Good evening and welcome to County Connections. My name is Alan Piper and I'm a transportation planner with the Berks County Planning Commission. This show is normally hosted by a county commissioner, but Commissioner Leinbach was not available for tonight's show and we'll be filling in for him. With me today is Mr. David Hunter, the new executive director of the Berks County Planning Commission. David's been with the county since the beginning of the year. Welcome to the Planning Commission and welcome to BCTV, your first time out.
Good evening. Thank you, Alan. It's good to be here.
We'll spend some time first talking to Dave about the Planning Commission and his goals for the coming year, and then we'll wrap up with some discussions about transportation funding and projects. So, Dave, what is planning?
What is planning? I love this question because I get it all the time and most people don't know what it is. They ask me, what is a planter? I said, no, planning. What is planning? The goal of planning is to maximize the health, safety, and economic well-being of all people living in our communities. So this involves critical thinking by professionals who look at the three pillars of transportation. The traditional pillars of transportation, of planning rather, are transportation planning, land use planning, and environmental planning. So these three, for transportation, we look at how we move around in our community. We look at how we can attract and retain business, where we live, how we recreate, and finally, how we can maintain and preserve our natural resources. So again, environmental planning, land use planning, transportation planning are the three pillars of planning. What does planning do? Planning helps create communities of lasting value, and in the words of Barry Schlauf, he's a former Planning Commission chairman, I love this quote. He says, planning guides the highest and best use of our precious resources. This is our land in Berks County. And so planning is mandated by the state code. Every jurisdiction in Pennsylvania municipality is required to have a land use plan. And so the role of planners in preparing, I have my little Vanna White little planning. This is the Berks County Comprehensive Plan update. It was adopted in January of this year. Very proud of it. And so planners worked hard over a number of years to do several things. To connect, we join people and agencies and municipalities in Berks County. Planners collaborate. We work with everyone that's interested in the planning process. We cooperate with all the municipalities and stakeholders in the county to the same end as to do the planning and come up with the comp plan. This is an update for 2030. We coordinate, which is a very important skill. We coordinate effective interaction of all the various parts of planning. And finally, and most importantly, we are to be effective communicators. If we don't have a clear exchange of information and ideas, then we have failed. So my goal at the Berks County Planning Commission as the executive director is to lead a qualified, bona fide professional staff who are very, very capable, Alan being one of them, and come up with the plan for transportation, for land use, for environment, and other areas. And so I think it's important to say that planners connect history. So we're looking back and we're connecting history. We are also looking at the future. So we're pulling the past forward to the present, but also we have to remain relevant to the present. So it's past, future, present. I think I got that right. So let's try this again. There'll be a pop quiz at the end. Planners connect the history of the past with the hope of the future while remaining relevant to the present. Everybody got that? Okay, so we'll do a pop quiz at the end, right? So also, planners are visionaries. Plans are visions for the future. And it's important that we clearly communicate the vision for Berks County and help all the municipalities to implement that vision. At the Berks County Planning Commission, the staff will strive for excellence as we seek to implement the best practices of the planning profession in Berks County. And our goal is professionalism. We interact with all the stakeholders and the municipalities in the county We want to do that at the highest and best level. So part of what we do, and Alan knows this, we have developed a work plan. And part of it is transportation. Alan's going to get into that in a little bit. But one of the major things we do after the adoption of the comprehensive plan, and I'll talk about that more, is that we work with municipalities to implement joint plans. So it's a comprehensive plan for the entire county, and then municipalities also have individual plans. We're working with several right now. So we work on joint plans. That's important. The bicycle and pedestrian plan is currently underway, and that's an important component of transportation. We don't just want to rely on motor vehicles. And
correct.
So that's important. The Greenway plan, we have had a kickoff meeting for the Greenway plan, and that's largely environmental. We want to preserve our corridors. We want to preserve our environmental corridors in the county, and so we're going to update our Greenway plan. There is also discussion of a Mount Prenn Preserve trail study. We've talked about that. The transportation long-range plan and the TIP. I'm getting into Alan's territory.
Stay out of there.
I'll stay out of that. We've also talked with jurisdictions about working on individual plans, town centers for some municipalities. We talked about that. We've also talked about housing and economic development. We talked about there's a new element in the comp plan on economic development. And last but not least, I want to talk about the census. One of our staff is one of the lead staff in working with the U.S. Department. It's not the Census Department. What are they called? They're under Commerce Department. The Commerce Department has the Bureau of the Census, and every 10 years, it's required by the Constitution that the United States count. And so the 2020 count is very important. For all those listening, please go out and vote, right? Vote meaning fill out your form when you get it by email or in the mail. We want to make sure that we count every person that lives in Berks County. So it's very important that we get a good count, because if we don't get a good count, we are underfunded by the federal government. So every person represents a specific dollar.
And that applies not only to housing programs,
yes,
and things like that. It
yes.
also applies to transportation
Absolutely.
Programs, recreational grants,
yes.
almost anything that you can think of that
yes.
you get money from the federal government
right.
from is based very largely on your responses to the census. So
yes. please
complete
yes.
surveys.
Absolutely, wanted to get that plug in. So that's our work plan. That's what planners do. So now you know what planners do, you know who planners are, and just touching on the update of the comprehensive plan, again, I want to make sure you get your copy of the right the Berks County Comprehensive Plan 2030 update, finally adopted in January this year. What we did, now just touch on the highlights. We updated the demographic and housing information in the plan. Again, Alan's area, the transportation element was updated. We have a chapter on economic development, and finally, there's a future land use plan. And so it's riveting reading, all right? If don't read it before you go to sleep. Don't do that. But, you know, get some coffee and peruse the plan, and you'll learn about how the Berks County will grow and develop along growth corridors, and how we preserve agriculture, and how we have planned for infrastructure improvements. So I enjoy planning. I hope you have a better understanding of what planning is and what planners do. Berks County Planning Commission, we now are head by the new Planning Commission Chair, Tom McCann, who is also Director of the Berks County Industrial Development Authority. We appreciate Tom's leadership, and staff supports the board, and staff does the studies and does the outreach with municipalities. And so it's fun. You have to enjoy what you do. I enjoy what I do. I have great staff, as I've mentioned already. And so, yes, if you have questions, please call in and ask Alan anything you want to know about transportation.
That's what's wrong with my phone. I think it's off the hook right now. You know, I think the one key, Dave, is the fact that, you know, it is a comprehensive plan, and the thing that a lot of people don't think about is you have a housing section, or you have a greenway section, or you have a transportation section. Right. And everybody can say, okay, well, I put this plan together, that plan together, or that plan together. Mm-hmm. But what we do is make sure that each of those parts work together with each other in that comprehensive plan. So there's not four separate plans all competing against each other. When you put those plans together, the goal is to put together a plan that clearly addresses the subject area and still interrelates and supports each of those other planning areas. So that's the goal of putting together a good comprehensive plan.
That's well said. One of the key words that I mentioned is coordination. So the plan has to be coordinated, and it has to be interrelated and work together so that it's not competing against each other. Transportation works with growth. All right, we're looking at growth along the growth corridors, and improving transportation networks is important to economic development in Berks County. So it's a very important piece, and we just look forward to implementing the plan as adopted.
All right.
Yeah.
So thanks for the update on the comprehensive plan.
Yes, sir.
Now we'll spend a little time talking about my favorite subject, transportation.
Yeah.
I know it's not everybody's favorite, but everybody drives, everybody gets goods, materials, food that uses some form of transportation in everything that you do. So it's a relatively important part of the overall plan. This has been a real interesting year, and I use that term very loosely this time, in terms of putting together our long-range transportation plan. We update our transportation plans, our four-year plan and our 30-year plan, or 20-year plan, 30-year plan. It's kind of out there. Every 2 years, based on information that we get from PennDOT, based on the funds that are available to us. Well, as we're developing our plan this year, starting to develop our plan this year, PennDOT made a policy decision that said, okay, there's only a certain amount of money that comes into Berks County, that comes into the state.
Right.
And they made a priority decision that more of that money was going to go towards the interstate system and away from projects that we consider important here in Berks County, such as the 422 corridor, the Westward Bypass corridor, the 222 North corridor, improvements to Route 61. Now, in saying that, it doesn't mean that all that money really disappeared out of Berks County, because we've got some very major, we may have some of the biggest interstate projects short of the Schuylkill, or not the Schuylkill Expressway, short of I-95 going on in Berks County right now, which is the reconstruction of Interstate 78 in the Greenwich Township area, and it's a project that's soon going to start for over $125 million for replacement of the bridge over the Schuylkill River on I-78 in Hamburg, and improvements to the Route 61 interchange up there. But as it comes back to the dollars that we directly work with here on non-interstate roads in Berks County, our base allocation is about $68 million less over the next 4 years than what we were anticipating under our last plan. And it's about $240 million less over the next 10 years. That led to some early discussion about the possibility of Berks County losing almost $700 million worth of projects. Now, we didn't lose $700 million. We only lost about $240 million. But because those funds are critical to the projects, those projects would not have been allowed to move forward. The 422 West Shore Bypass project was estimated to be roughly a $550 million project. At some one point, it was almost as high as $600 million. They managed to scale that back. We have over $100 million worth of work that we'd like to do on the 222 North corridor, extending from the work that's already underway right now in Maiden Creek Township all the way to the Lehigh County line. And another roughly $50 million on Route 61 and some of the other major corridors around the rest of the county. And those are just the major capital projects that we weren't going to be able to do. Well, PennDOT understood that certain areas were going to be really hard hit by that. Mm-hmm. And what they did is they have reserves that are available for the discretion of the Secretary of Transportation to allocate out to different areas of the state based mm-hmm. on need. And they made a decision early on to offer us $321 million, mm-hmm. all of which would have gone into the 422 West Shore Bypass Reconstruction Project.
But not enough to finish it.
But not enough to finish it, right. So they offered us that money, and then as we discussed that further, we had a lot of feedback from our board and others in the community about, hey, how come we're putting all of that money to the 420 to the West Shore Bypass, right. but we're not finishing what we started on Route 222.
Right.
So PennDOT came back and told us, okay, you now have the opportunity to begin or to consider shifting some of that money to the mm-hmm. 222 corridor. So we spent probably the better part of a month working with PennDOT, their engineers, their designers, their financial people, to try and go back and put things together. Mm-hmm. What we've managed to do with that, at least for now, I say at least for now because we're still in the process of developing our draft plan and moving forward to getting that officially approved by PennDOT. We won't reach a formal decision until probably locally July and by the state and the federal government not until mm-hmm. October 1st, which is the beginning of the new state fiscal year. But in any event, what we think that we're going to be able to do now is we think that we're going to be able to fully fund the design and reconstruction of the next piece of 222, which mm-hmm. would extend from where the construction is going on now in Maiden Creek Township, roughly in the area of Schaefer Road, all the way north to the Kutztown Bypass.
Great.
And what we'd be looking at in that corridor is widening the highway to two lanes in each direction, and probably adding an additional roundabout or two at Richmond Road and at Pleasant Hills Road. What that would do would give us really a significant increase mm-hmm. in the capacity of that corridor,
right.
With limited congestion, greatly improving the safety of that corridor. That mm-hmm. was the most dangerous corridor in the county. It was also among mm-hmm. the most congested
Ouch.
In the county. So that was one of the reasons that we really felt the need to get money back into that project.
Right
now, that project is probably going to cost about $78 million total. Now, that's mm-hmm. more than the money that we moved out of the discretionary funding because we had some money on the project to begin with, but
right.
we've managed to shuffle things around. We hope to be able to get this to beginning that construction roughly in the 2023-2024 timeframe. Mm-hmm. We're also making a real big jump to move forward with the 422 corridor. As it stands right now, using most of that discretionary money that we have coming from the state, we're looking at almost a $380 million project to reconstruct portions of the West Shore Bypass. I got to look at my cheat sheet on this to make sure I remember exactly what we're doing. An initial phase that we looked at there would be to reconstruct the bridge that's just west of the Interstate 176 ramp. It's a bridge that's been troublesome to PennDOT. We'd widen that to three lanes. The goal of the whole 422 project is to widen the entire highway from Route 12 all the way to just east of 176 to three lanes in each direction. Mm. We'd like to do that bridge and improve that connection to the northbound to westbound 176 ramp. There's a lot of accidents in that area as well. Mm. We'd make major preventative maintenance projects to the other two river crossings on either side of that. And then the real large portion of the project that we'd be getting into there is the reconstruction of the what I'll call the central portion of the West Shore Bypass that starts just east of the Lancaster Avenue interchange, runs through the Lancaster Avenue interchange, runs through the Penn Street interchange, and runs all the way up to the Buttonwood Street Bridge. Within that area, both interchanges would be completely reconstructed. The highway would be widened to three through lanes in each direction. All of the ramps would be built and designed for the appropriate level of current and future traffic through that area. And one of the areas that we've been spending a lot of time on is, because this is right in the heart of our urban area, we're spending a lot of time talking about the issues related to the movement of bicycles and pedestrians back and forth through those corridors. We've got a lot of people that go back and forth across the Penn Street Bridge. We've got a lot of people that go across the Binghamton Street Bridge. You have the Toon Trail that runs through that entire corridor.
Right.
So the goal is to try and put this project together in a way that accommodates all of those modes together and works as one project. That's probably not going to get started until roughly 2026, somewhere in that neighborhood. There's an awful lot of work that needs to happen between now and then related to finalizing the designs, acquiring the properties, working our way through all of those issues of getting everything going. It's probably going to end up being a 4 to 5 or maybe even longer year project to actually get out there and construct it. Right. And one of the reasons that it takes that long is the fact that because that highway is so important to our community. The way we're going to have to try and build that is in a way that we can keep two lanes of traffic open in each direction at all times. Can you imagine what the bypass would be like if we had it down to one lane in each direction for 5 years in a row?
Sure. That speaks to, Alan, the connection between land use planning and transportation planning and how it has to be coordinated.
Absolutely.
I mean, 422 is the lifeblood of our region, along with 222. So just practically, how does the lack of funding affect our economy, in your opinion?
Well, what you need to look at is people come to our region based on what they think our improvements are going to be. So our prior plan said, yes, we're going to do this, and we had time frames that went along with that. So now we're saying, oh, wait a minute, that stuff that we thought we were going to do, we're not going to be able to get to that now, or maybe we're not going to be able to get to that later.
Right.
And what's the biggest driver of that is it's the fact that you've got to commute, or your products, if you're a company, is moving through that highway system.
Right.
So if I have unsafe conditions, or I have congestion, or things like that, that's costing you your time and money and safety of your employees in terms of your ability to do that. So anything that we can do to clear up the bottlenecks and the safety improvements in the county is something that we look highly at. So in support of the comp plan and in support of our separate long-range transportation plan is we have other reports that we work on. It's a congestion management report that looks at major corridors around the county that documents the amount of congestion, what's causing that, what can we do? Now, obviously, the 222 corridor is an area where all of our capacity and our safety problems is caused by the fact that we've got at least 4 lanes worth of traffic trying to use a two-lane road as a major link, not only between Reading and the Lehigh Valley, but also as a part of a link that extends all the way from Route 30 through the city of from York through Lancaster to Reading and then into the Lehigh Valley and on to the New York and New England metropolitan region. So it's a really a key corridor.
Yes.
So we need to keep it up and keep moving on working to find solutions to that.
Absolutely.
It stands right now, even if we fund that last project that I talked about to the Kutztown Bypass, we're still talking about a gap that goes from the Kutztown Bypass into Lehigh County, and there's still going to be a gap on their side that needs to be addressed, getting all the way into the Route 100 bypass in Trexler Town. So we'll keep plugging away on that. We'll keep looking for money on that issue. We'll certainly have a lot of pressure on us from the community right now to go out and find every dollar that we can to get PennDOT to give us every dollar that we can get back from them. And then to go out and find any discretionary funding from state and federal resources that we can to keep things moving.
Right. It speaks to, again, our economic well-being. It speaks to the well-being of every citizen in the community and how healthy our community is. So very important work Alan does. It's tied to the plan and the implementation of the plan.
All right.
Yep.
Well, I think, Dave, I think you did pretty well for your first time out.
Well, thank you, Alan. I appreciate that. You're a great host. I'll tell Alan his job's in jeopardy. You're Alan. I'll tell Chairman Christian Leinbach that his job's in jeopardy.
All right. Well, thank you all for watching. Yes. And be sure to tune in to BCTV. Thank you, and have a great evening.
Thank you all.